Thank you for joining me. Today we're going to discuss what you can do to get rid of low back pain. Low back pain is a very troubling and common occurrence, and there are many things you can do. If you have low back pain, you can get massage, you can go to the chiropractor. Make sure that you are wearing shoes that have good support and that do not have a heel to them. Make sure that those shoes are regularly replaced. Tennis shoes break down particularly quickly, so you need to be cautious of that. You can massage yourself with tennis balls, but I'm going to go over five things that you can do. First thing that I recommend, and this is what I find to be the most important, is pay attention to your alignment. Throughout the day, we're busy, we're moving from this to that, we're standing, we're sitting, we're driving, we're going. Pay attention to your form. Pay attention to how you're doing everything right up until you get into bed at night. Pay attention to your movements and what you're doing with your body, because it's likely that part of your back pain is coming from, I'll call them, nonsensical habits that you've created through the years. Pay attention to when you're seated at your chair and you start typing, does your pelvis tuck under you? Likewise, pay attention to when you sit down in your car to start driving and you grab the steering wheel, does your pelvis tuck under you? That's going to be something that's going to cause you low back pain. And I've got some videos on alignment when you're in standing, alignment when you're seated, and alignment for when you're quadruped. So look over those videos and educate yourself about proper alignment, and then monitor yourself throughout the day and see how you do. Next, I'm going to recommend forward bending. If you don't have a bulging disc, forward bending is a great way to go because it provides a natural traction. Now, I'll show you what to do. We're going to come from the seated position here, which you could come from standing. We want our feet to be right under our sits bones. And you want to have a good bend under or behind your knees. And then you're going to let yourself relax forward. Now, to be in this position, really the only thing we're looking for is for the pelvis to rotate up toward the ceiling. As the pelvis rotates up, it's going to lower the spine, it's going to lower the head, and then we have the opportunity to use gravity to help us create a natural traction through the spine. We use gravity and it helps elongate the spinal muscles, as opposed to all day long when it really compresses the spine and the muscles can shorten. So here we're in a position where the spine can lengthen and the muscles can lengthen too. Now you can have your hands down here, or you can grab your elbows, whatever is most comfortable for you. Good. And go ahead and let's make our way back down to the mat. Now, like I said, those forward folds are really beneficial if you do not have a bulging disc. If you have a bulging disc and the disc is bulging the wrong way, this can cause incredible pain for you. And if that's your situation, if when you bend forward it causes pain, this is not the time to decide to breathe through that. Just stop. Just stop and go to see your doctor and get some imaging for your back. And that brings me to another point. If you feel like you have a very serious pain, you really need to go see your doctor. Nothing in this video is intended to be a replacement of advice from a medical professional. So if you're feeling a significant amount of pain, please go see a doctor. They can get you prescriptions to help you feel better, but they can also prescribe imaging to figure out exactly what is the cause of your pain. Okay, next up, step number three. We're going to do some imprint and some rib cage placement. Now, I've gone over this before. There are videos for it, so I'm going to just be brief here, but I want you on your back with your heels in line with your sits bones. You're going to take your thumbs and your pointer fingers and connect them. Then you're going to bring the heels of your hands to the outside of your hips and your pointer fingers touch on your pubis. Now when you look up, your pubis and your hips should be in the same plane. And you notice that because your hands are flat in that plane. Okay, so now once you've got that neutral pelvis, I want you to come up, feel your rib cage, and you'll notice it feels kind of like a cylinder. Right now my ribs are really angled forward, so I'm gonna find the muscles on the front of the ribs to help angle them down so that my rib cage is pointed down toward my pelvis. That's gonna help hold all the organs in your body cavity. It's gonna help your muscles work correctly as well. When the rib cage flares out like that, it really kind of gets everything askew, and you can have lots of muscles just really uncertain of what they're supposed to be doing, how they're supposed to be working, and they just decide to sit out. Okay, so it's important to get this good alignment so that the muscles will be active when they're supposed to. All right, so we've got the rib cage placed, and we've got the pelvis placed. Now, we're going to do some imprint, and I'm gonna reach my arms up so that you can see how much my pelvis moves. You see I've got a curve to my low back. Inhale into the sides of the ribs. And then as you exhale, the low belly draws toward the spine and the pelvis tilts. Inhale to return back to neutral. And exhale. We'll just do one more. And get the pelvis back to neutral. Double check, make sure the ribs have still stayed engaged, and they have. Okay, next, after you've done imprint, after you challenge the rib cage to stay in place, you can do some gentle twisting. So to start off with, I like to take my feet nice and wide, and then I'll let my arms come out by my sides. We're gonna windshield wiper our legs. So bring your feet to the outside edge of your mat and turn the toes out. Now you're going to let your knees drop to one side and then the other. And just nice and easy, they're gonna go back and forth, loosening up muscles that you'll need for rotation. Good. Now, let's come on to our sides. We're going to do spinal rotation in two other ways. We're going to have the knees in from the hips, the arms reaching out in front. You're going to inhale the top arm up and exhale, rotate open. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, the top arm comes back up. And then exhale, close, and we'll switch sides. Get right up on that bottom arm, shoulder. Knees are straight in front of you, ankles in line with the knees. Inhale, the top arm up. Exhale, rotate open. Hold and breathe. Inhale, rotate up to center, and exhale, close. So now for our lower body rotation, roll onto your back and bring the legs up to tabletop. Again, we're going to reach the arms out by the sides. Inhale here. Now we're going to keep the ribs down. We're going to rock onto the right hip and then lower the feet away from you. So wherever those feet need to go so that they can touch down, upper body stays firmly in place, lower body rotates, and breathe. Turn your head the opposite direction of your knees. Okay, good. Come back to center. Walk your feet to center, lift them back up to tabletop, and we're going the other way. Let the abdominals come toward the spine, up and over onto the other hip. Let the feet lower down. Turn to look out away from the knees. And come back to center. Good, nice and easy. Roll on to your side. And this is going to be how you want to get up. If you're on the floor, you want to roll on to your side. If you're in your bed, you want to roll on to your side. Use your arms to press you up. And that's how you want to get up to a seated position. There's one more thing that I consider a step in terms of addressing back pain, and it's really just a thought. And the thought is this. You might feel your back pain in a specific place, but it doesn't mean that it's coming from that area. So when you're doing stretches, when you're trying to think about your posture and alignment and what you could be doing, don't just think about that spot where it hurts. Really do try to think about everything, because when you can see the bigger picture, it's more likely that you're going to find whatever is causing you the problem. I want to thank you guys for watching this video, and if you liked it, give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. If you'd like more information, you can find me on my website, www.custompilatesandyoga.com. Thank you.